Now let's move to neurological disorders. Brain is particularly vulnerable to oxidation and it has high oxygen consumption. Actually, 20% of all oxygen and 25% of all glucose are consumed by brain functions. Also, brain contains a very high content of polyunsaturated fatty acids, which are very sensitive to oxidation. Antioxidative system or levels of antioxidant enzymes in the brain are modest. And also in the brain, we have a very high content of redoxative metals that are able to promote production of free radicals. Having all this in mind, it's pretty clear that our brain cells need protection from oxidation, from free radical oxidation. And this protection can be provided by using antioxidants that are able to penetrate through a blood-brain barrier. L-carnosine is one of those antioxidants. And L-carnosine is actually universal neuroprotector because evolution made sure that young and healthy nerve cells have enough of L-carnosine while they are young to protect these important cells from oxidative damage and from degeneration. L-carnosine is helping in many neurological disorders, mainly by its antioxidative, anti-glycating, and anti-carbonylating properties. Let's move to the first of neurological disorders. I would like to say something about Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease affects more than 30 million people worldwide right now. And I'm not sure if you are aware of the fact, but that number is expected to increase four times to up to 120 million people worldwide by the year 2050. That is, Alzheimer's disease will represent a real clinical and social problem in the next years. The right treatment for Alzheimer's disease has not been found until now. What is actually Alzheimer's disease? Alzheimer's disease is a slowly progressive neurological disease that is characterized by loss of memory. In Alzheimer's disease, the brain cells degenerate and die, causing a steady decline in mental and cognitive functions. What is actually happening in Alzheimer's disease? If we reveal the cause and understand the pathology of some diseases, we will know how to help the patients in the best way. Many scientists think that accumulation and production of amyloid beta proteins is responsible for causing Alzheimer's disease. What is actually happening in Alzheimer's disease? So here is the cell membrane of the nerve cell, and the proteins in the cell membrane are secreting the alpha beta proteins. Then those proteins undergo aggregation and forming oligomers. And those oligomers are then inserting into the plasma membrane, causing lipid peroxidation, which will eventually lead to reduced ATP production, reduced antioxidant defense, and increased oxidative stress. L-carnosine is able to block and inhibit activity of this beta amyloid protein and therefore can prevent development of the dementia. And also in the brains of those affected by Alzheimer's disease, it is found higher concentration of zinc. We now know that zinc-induced neurotoxicity plays important role in Alzheimer's disease. L-carnosine is able to chelate that zinc and to prevent zinc-induced neurotoxicity and thus prevent the development of vascular dementia, for example. Now let's move to Parkinson disease. Parkinson disease is a chronic neurodegenerative disease that is characterized by loss of dopaminergic neurons. Here we have a loss of neurons. It is clinically manifested as severe motor symptoms that include, for example, uncontrolled resting tremor, bradykinesia, rigidity, and postural imbalance. Parkinson's disease is twice as likely to affect men and a woman, and one medication has been the gold standard in treatment of Parkinson's disease over the last 5 decades, and that is L-DOPA. What is actually happening in the brain when Parkinson's disease is presented? In the brain, we have something that is called Lewy body, and those Lewy bodies accumulate alpha-synuclein, which accelerate the development of these diseases. We now know that alpha-synuclein is generated during oxidative stress, and by preventing oxidative stress and reducing oxidative stress, L-carnosine is able to help patients with Parkinson's disease. Actually, there is a clinical study that was conducted in Russia where the scientists and the doctors added 1.5 grams of L-carnosine per day along with L-DOPA therapy, and significantly improvement in terms of coordination have been observed in these patients. And also scientists observed that L-carnosine were able to prevent toxic effect of L-DOPA, which include abnormal heart rhythm and aggressive behavior. Also, if you remember when I said that there are some enzymes called carnosinases that are able to degrade the carnosine to L-histidine and beta-alanine. What is very interesting, I found one paper where this fact is shown. In the brains of those affected by Parkinson's disease, scientists found higher concentration of these enzymes, meaning that those patients don't have enough carnosine in their brains because it is quickly degraded because of presence of these enzymes. And this may tell us why we are witnessing such a great results with the patients with Parkinson's diseases. Then we have epilepsy. More than 50 million people worldwide are suffering from epilepsy. Epilepsy is the most common neurological disorder, and it is characterized by loss of unprovoked recurrent seizures. Epilepsy is also present in 20 to 50% of patients who have autistic spectrum disorders. And as many things about autistic spectrum disorders we don't know, the same thing here is with epilepsy. A lot of things about epilepsy we don't know, but there are certain facts that are well researched so far. Let's go through some of them. First, we know that in epilepsy is present impairment of mitochondrial function or impairment of mitochondrial dysfunction. Then we have neuronal death through apoptosis. We are witnessing mutation of mitochondrial DNA. We have decreased ATP. We have decreased histamine levels. And it is found that zinc and copper are bounded to GABA receptors. How L-carnosine is able to help people who have epilepsy? In different ways. First, L-carnosine is able to improve mitochondrial function and to increase ATP production, and thus L-carnosine can decrease duration and series of the epileptic seizures. Then, if you remember, L-carnosine is composed of beta-alanine L-histidine. L-histidine chemically can be transferred to histamine, and histamine, when released, can suppress seizures. Actually, L-carnosine can serve in the brain as a reservoir for histamine, which, when released, can suppress and prevent epileptic seizures. And the third one, we know that GABA is the major inhibitory neurotransmitter in the brain, and actually it suppresses nerve excitation. What is happening in epilepsy? GABA, to show its activity and to suppress seizures, needs to be attached to receptor. In epilepsy, those receptors can be full of zinc and copper ions, and therefore GABA cannot attach to that receptor and show its activity. L-carnosine, with its chelating properties, is able to chelate and remove copper and zinc from the receptor, and therefore allow GABA to attach to that receptor and to suppress the seizures. And those are the mechanisms where L-carnosine helps people with epilepsy. I really hope, and many scientists can agree with me, that L-carnosine can be used as a strong anticonvulsant agent in the future, because many anticonvulsant agents today have very serious side effects. L-carnosine doesn't have any side effect. And I have to say that we have many patients with pharmacoresistant epilepsies. Those are epilepsies that do not respond to any known and conventional treatment and drug. And L-carnosine succeeded in reducing the frequency of seizures in those patients. Psychiatric disorders are increasing globally and already rank among the top causes of disability worldwide. And they are expecting to take over the first place in the next decades. Actually, study of mood disorders among population of 30 European countries suggests that 138 million people, which is around 38% of the population, will have a fully developed mental illness in 1 year. Houston, we have a problem, right? Many stress-related and depressive disorders are associated with one or more of the following. Those are shortened telomeres, raised cortisol levels, and increased sensitivity to age-related mitochondrial dysfunctions. How L-carnosine can help with stress and with depressive disorders? First, it can enhance the cortisol metabolism. It can suppress telomere shortening, and it can increase anti-age activity in the model system. Actually, L-carnosine is able to suppress stress and to improve behavior, cognition, and well-being in human subjects. Our patients are reporting that they feel better and that they have increased adaptation mechanisms to stress. There are no mood oscillation when they are using carnosine. They feel mentally stronger. They have more will to do things. And we know that everything comes from the head. And when you feel optimistic, when you feel great, recovery from any disease is much, much faster and more successful. Also, study on rats showed that L-carnosine was able to accelerate the metabolizing of cortisol and noradrenaline, which are delivered into the blood when animals are under the stress. Shortly put, L-carnosine can remove cortisol and noradrenaline from the blood. And also many depressive, many patients who have depression are found to have increased inflammatory markers. Depression is now being considered in some studies that is also inflammatory diseases, and we know that L-carnosine can reduce inflammation by reducing levels of inflammatory cytokines, and therefore that can be one of the mechanisms where L-carnosine can help patients with depression. Stroke is another age-related threat, and it is the third cause of death among Americans. Almost 500,000 people annually suffer from stroke. 80% of strokes are what we know as ischemic strokes. And even though the consequences of stroke are mainly neurological, the cause is lying in pathology of the brain arteries. And when the stroke happens, there are some cells in the brain that are highly affected by hypoxia, by a lack of oxygen. And those cells are going through huge trauma. They are becoming necrotic and they will eventually die. And we can do nothing about it. However, there are cells around that affected area that are still alive, but they don't function properly. When we feed, though, they don't have enough energy to function. When we feed those cells with oxygen, those cells will slowly start to recover, and we will have improvement in some of the symptoms. I would like to show you results of one study where the stroke was simulated by arterial occlusion of four main cephalic arteries. Those rats were pre-treated with carnosine, and they measured their lactate levels. Lactate levels are just a measurement of injury severity. And the blue one are the rats pre-treated with carnosine. The red one are without carnosine. And you can see how significantly less lactate accumulation we are witnessing when rats are pre-treated with carnosine. Actually, L-carnosine succeeded in acting like a neuroprotector in the ischemic brain. Those rats had obviously less lactate accumulation. They have better electrocardiograms, and they have better cerebral blood flow. Shortly put, they were better when they were pre-treated with L-carnosine.